Strong curves, that's what we're going to be talking about today, but more specifically, how to grow your chest. Are you ready for it? Let's get into it. At the time of filming this video, I now have 3,500 subscribers. Oh my god! Like, holy what the For those of you who are new, thank you so much for subscribing. I'm so glad you're here. I love helping you guys out. This is a big deal for me and I'm just so happy that you guys are liking my channel. So thank you, I love you. Aww. This is a question I get a lot. You know, what exercises can I do to
increase my chest? How can I grow my boobs? Or I've lost weight or I've breastfed, my boobs are straight, my boobs are saggy, how can I get tighter boobs?
I get it, it's a big insecurity. It's something that I've actually dealt with personally myself. So I wanted to make this video because there's so much crap out there. If you YouTube this and look at what other fitness people are telling you to do, just no, 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 no. First of all, I'm just gonna be really straight up and just come out with it. Short answer, there are no exercises that are gonna grow your boobs. I'm sorry.
Hello darkness, my old friend, I've come to talk with you again.
Your boobs are made of fat, and you can't train fat, you can only train muscle. I'm gonna insert a diagram, like a cross section of the female breast, so you can actually understand anatomically what's going on here. As you can see, the breast is actually made of glands and fat, but underneath that you have the pectoral muscles and the pec minor and the pec major. Now the pec major is like almost like a fan shape that sits across the chest underneath your boobs, and it attaches at your arm and at your rib cage. How much breast tissue you have largely comes down to your genetics and your lifestyle. Growing or shrinking your boobs comes down to either gaining or losing body fat. That's it. So really, if you want to have bigger boobs, apart from surgery or sock stuffing your bra, you're just going to have to gain more body fat. And how you gain more body fat is through diet. But generally what happens when you start a fit and healthy lifestyle, you start lifting weights, is that your body composition changes, meaning you gain more muscle and you lose body fat. This is a great thing for your abs and your booty, but not so much for your bra size. This is like the typical fit girl problem, isn't it? So when you lose body fat, you're probably gonna lose your boobs too. It's just the way it is. Chest exercises aren't gonna grow your boobs because you can't train breast fat, right? You can only train your pecs. That's what chest exercises are gonna do. They're gonna work your pec muscle that sits underneath your boob. All that's gonna do is grow you some lovely sculpted man pecs.
I'm sexy and I know it.
Now, I don't know about you, but I am not a fan of the well-defined pec look. I like it on my boyfriend, but not so much on me in a bikini. So if you want to keep whatever boobs you do have and maintain a strong yet feminine looking body, then overdoing the chest exercises is going to do absolutely nothing for you. In fact, it's going to do quite the opposite. I'm gonna talk you through what you should and shouldn't be doing in the gym to make sure that you don't shrink those gals any further. So the question is, should women even train their chest? Well, here's what I think. No. No, I'm not saying that you need to completely avoid working your upper body, because of course a lot of us women tend to be very weak in our upper body, and so gaining strength is super important. But there's a right way to do it and a wrong way to do it. And most of these fitness girls out there that you're watching that are telling you to train chest and do all these crazy exercises, they've got it wrong. I need to call bullshit on these people. And here's where it gets tricky with chest training, because the leaner you get, i.e. the less body fat you have, the more defined your muscles are gonna look. They're gonna pop out more. You're gonna look more muscular. But the issue is that generally speaking, for most women, the part of our body that already is the leanest, it tends to be here, our décolletage. So when you do diet down or lose body fat, this is going to look even leaner. If you're extremely lean on this part of your body, but also very well developed, as in you've been doing a lot of chest exercises, you're going to have a lot of definition on your pecs. It's gonna look more masculine, it's gonna look more muscular. But on the other hand, if you hold a lot of body fat up here, then training your chest without losing body fat probably isn't gonna make any difference whatsoever. The question is, how do you actually train your upper body, gain upper body strength, but without shrinking your boobs any further so that you can maintain a feminine and curvy body? Oh, itchy nose. Oh my God. Ugh. This is pretty obvious, guys. The more weight you lift, the harder that muscle that you're targeting is going to work under that heavy load, and therefore the more it will grow. And this is obviously assuming that you have good activation through that muscle and that your form is correct. So going for progressive overload, which basically just means adding more weight and more reps over time, is not really the best idea. So you want to avoid any chest pressing, basically, with heavy weight. Heavy weighted barbell press, dumbbell chest press, incline chest press, because obviously that's just gonna grow and define your pec muscle. What's an isolation exercise? It's an exercise that isolates one specific muscle to do the work, as opposed to a compound exercise which uses multiple muscle groups. So for example, a squat is a compound exercise because you use your core and your quads, hamstrings, glutes, and your calves in order to lift that weight up and down. But on the other hand, a leg extension exercise is going to isolate your quads, meaning it's going to make your thigh muscles do all of the work. So why are isolation exercises a no-go for your chest? So stay with me, this is gonna make sense. Say you're gonna squat 20 kilos. Because it's a compound exercise, that weight gets distributed throughout all the muscles you're using to perform the lift. So let's say that your quads take 40% of that weight that you're lifting, so 8 out of those 20 kilos is lifted by your quads. Does that make sense? Now, let's take 20 kilos on a leg extension machine. Well, your quads are isolated there, so they're doing all of the work. None of your other muscles are taking the brunt of that weight, meaning your quads are lifting 20 kilos. Which one is going to grow more muscle? 20 kilos on a squat or 20 kilos on a leg extension? The 20 kilos on a leg extension. So basically, on a leg extension machine, your quads are actually lifting more weight, which means that they're gonna grow more. So the last thing that you wanna do is target your pec muscles directly, because the more you isolate them, the more defined they're gonna look. You want to avoid isolation exercises like the cable flies or dumbbell flies or even the pec deck machine. The more often you train a muscle, the more it's gonna grow. So typically I tell my girls that if they wanna grow their glutes, then training them once a week is not enough. You've gotta train them at least 2 to 3 times a week. But with your chest, less is more. So don't feel pressured like you have to dedicate a whole session just to training your chest every week because, you know, you see other girls do it in the gym. You can still gain strength by training your chest less frequently. Well, there's not a lot, to be honest. And in my opinion, the only decent chest exercise that you should be doing is the trusted old push-up. It's a great compound movement that builds upper body strength without isolating the chest and building any definition there. It'll also work your core, your shoulders, your arms. It's just a really good general upper body exercise. So if you're one of those girls that like smashes out the dumbbell chest press, but you can't even do a full set of push-ups, you definitely have your priorities wrong. If you're a beginner, you can do it from the knees, you can do it elevated, you can do just a conventional push-up, you can mess around with the width of of your hands. You can do narrow, you can do diamond if you want to target more of the back of your arms as well. There's so many variations. Now, I haven't filmed a workout for you guys because this would have been the longest video ever, but if you are actually interested in seeing how you incorporate this move into an upper body training session, let me know in the comments below if you'd like me to film that workout, because I'm more than happy to do that. There you go, guys. I hope that was helpful. I'm sorry it's probably not the answer that you were looking for, but it is the truth. It's just a part of being female. It's just the way it is. Short of having surgery, there's not much else that you can do. But I hope that that clears things up for you. And of course, I do believe that just generally training your upper body, getting strong in your upper body is going to help. It's not going to be the 100% cure for loose, saggy boobs. I'm sorry. But if you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to hit that subscribe, and I'll catch you very soon in another video. Bye.